This is Parish of Jarrow and Simonside. It's Tuesday the 17th of August. Good morning, Judith. You can't hear me.
Let's try this.
How's that, Judith? Is that better? Morning, Carol. Morning, Evelyn. Morning, Sunny. Is the sound any better now? I hope it is. I'd put the microphone on my cardigan, then decided to take the cardigan off. It is early. Thank you, Judith, for that sound check. Thank you, Sunny. Oh, I don't know about you, but the horror that's unfolding on the news is just... beyond words, really. So we will be praying for everyone in Afghanistan this morning. A friend has shared a prayer that I think we can use today. Perhaps we hold everything in our mind, you know, everything in our hearts as we go through our service this morning. Good morning, Emma. I'm just looking for the prayer now. I thought I'd saved it, but we'll need that for the service. So shall we be still for just a moment as we get ready together to say a daily prayer. We'll just breathe. Breathing in. And out. Words from Psalm 46. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am. Be still and know. Be still. Be. I welcome you this morning in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. O Lord, open our lips and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Blessed are you, Creator of all. To you be praise and glory forever. As your dawn renews the face of the earth, bringing light and life to all creation, may we rejoice in this day you have made as we wake refreshed from the depths of sleep. Open our eyes to behold your presence, and strengthen our hands to do your will, that the world may rejoice and give you praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. The night has passed and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Our psalm this morning is Psalm 87. And the refrain is, the Lord has chosen Zion for himself. The Lord has chosen Zion for himself. His foundation is on the holy mountains. The Lord loves the gates of Zion more than all the dwellings of Jacob. Glorious things are spoken of you, Zion, city of our God. I record Egypt and Babylon as those who know me. Behold Philistia, Tyre, and Ethiopia. In Zion they were born. And of Zion it shall be said, each one was born in her. And the Most High himself has established her. The Lord will record as he writes up the peoples. This one also was born there. And as they dance, they shall sing. All my fresh springs are in you. The Lord has chosen Zion for himself. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our canticle this morning, words from Isaiah chapter 2, is a song of peace. The refrain at the beginning and the end is, Spirit of God, teach us your ways, that we may walk in the paths of peace. Spirit of God, teach us your ways, that we may walk in the paths of peace. Come, let us go up to the mountain of God, to the house of the God of Jacob, that God may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths. For the law shall go out from Zion, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. God shall judge between the nations and shall mediate for many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. O people of Jacob, come. Let us walk in the light of the Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Spirit of God, teach us your ways, that we may walk in the paths of peace. Our Gospel reading this morning is from the Gospel of St. Mark, chapter 5, beginning at verse 21 through to 34. Mark 5, 21 to 34. When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a great crowd gathered round him, and he was by the lake. Then one of the leaders of the synagogue, named Jairus, came, and when he saw him, fell at his feet and begged him repeatedly, "My little girl is at the point of death. Come and lay your hands on her so that she may be made well and live." So he went with him. And a large crowd followed him and pressed in on him. Now there was a woman who had been suffering from hemorrhages for 12 years. She had endured much under many physicians and had spent all that she had, and she was no better, but rather grew worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. For she said, "If I but touch his clothes, I will be made well." Immediately her hemorrhage stopped, and she felt in her body that she was healed of her disease. Immediately aware that power had gone from him, Jesus turned about in the crowd and said, "Who touched my clothes?" And his disciples said to him, "You see the crowd pressing in on you. How can you say, 'Who touched me?'" He looked all round to see who had done it. But the woman, knowing what had happened to her, came in fear and trembling, fell down before him, and told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. And we'll just pause. wonder, has anything resonated for you from our reading this morning? For Judith, daughter, that's how Jesus speaks to the woman who reached out to touch his cloak and was healed. Daughter. The new relationship, because she was no longer excluded. Daughter. Thank you, Judith. And this poor woman who had suffered quite publicly and been excluded because of her ailment, the thing that gripped her body, was restored very publicly in front of the crowd. For Tracy, it was the words, "All my fresh springs are in you." That struck me, she said. Then the woman needed only the tiniest touch to be healed, a tiny trickle of faith that flows into an outpouring of love that will make her a fresh witness to pour life out to others. Thank you, Tracy. A wonderful way to look into this, to look deeper. The slightest touch and the witness of this woman that's led to a mighty river of faith down the generation. I know when I was working in a school at the top of the hill and attending a church at the bottom of the hill, I would see my time spent at the Eucharist at the bottom of the hill as refreshing that water, that living water, and taking it up the hill and pouring it out in another place. Carol, the woman had so much faith in Jesus to know his touch would heal her. It's as if she's heard, she knew, she recognised him, and she had a very small window in which to take action and to reach out. He's dashing to save a little girl. So I'm guessing he was in a hurry and the crowds were constantly closing in. So that was a decisive action, wasn't it? I think to see this reading of all the readings this morning for me, just heartbreaking to see what's happening in the world, but to see what's happening in Afghanistan, to see the messages coming out of there crying out for help to the rest of the world through social media is heartbreaking. To hear the pleas to support women and girls is heartbreaking. And here we have a gospel reading, which is about healing a woman and a girl. We haven't got the bit with Jairus's daughter, perhaps that will be tomorrow. And it just makes me think of the perfect love, even in a time when Jesus' ministry was unfolding, as we heard this morning, even at a time where women and girls were seen in a and a lesser way, as is still the case in some parts of the world. God's love reached out to them. Jesus calls this woman daughter. Perhaps that's how we know about faith and God and trust and love and hope. In that, no one should be excluded or hurt by it or held back by it, discriminated against, managed. Daughter, he calls her daughter. Your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease. It's hard for me this morning to separate the woman and girl, the woman and girl in our reading, and the woman and girl in our story. Tracy has put listening to it on the radio this morning. It just makes you cry. And how can anyone deny people asylum from that? Perhaps I can just share with you this prayer now. So it was shared by a friend on Facebook, Carl, this morning. It's by Grace Pengelly Beckett. And my friends put this. In the absence of words of my own, in the face of the current situation, I thought it might be helpful to share hers, her prayer, her words. So I'll share this with you now. So this is a prayer for Afghanistan. Heavenly Father, this morning, we offer you this prayer and others' words, which also resonate much with our hearts. As we seek for those who are fleeing sanctuary, for those who are staying safety, for those who are fighting peace, for those whose hearts are breaking comfort, for those who see no future hope. Amen. We pray for everyone in Afghanistan and all places in the world who are hurting today. And let's hope that the UN and governments and all involved can react. So shall we respond to Scripture, trusting and knowing the living God who calls each of us daughter and son, brother and sister. Our words for the response this morning are from Psalm 119. Open my eyes, O Lord, that I may see the wonders of your law. Open my eyes, O Lord, that I may see the wonders of your law. Lead me in the path of your commandments, that I may see the wonders of your law. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Open my eyes, O Lord, that I may see the wonders of your law. And the words of the Benedictus, the Song of Zechariah. The refrain at the very beginning and the end is, in your tender compassion, O God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us. In your tender compassion, O God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Pardon me. Amen. In your tender compassion, O God, the dawn from on high shall break upon. Time now for our prayers. Please continue to pray for one another. Power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Loving God, you have replaced hearts of stone with hearts of flesh. All whom you call, I hope, see the world differently. We do our best to look at the world as through your eyes, to look out with forgiveness and peace and hope. Some days, this sensing, this knowing, this feeling, this being can just just be overwhelming when we see what is happening in this world. We pray for change. We long for your kingdom here on earth, in all places and all spaces. We pray for the day when all will truly be seen as equal. When nature is respected. Where war is no more, just thinking of the words from Isaiah. Swords turned into pruning hooks. Lord, this morning we pray for all those places in the world where refugees flee, where people are so desperate they gather in camps with their children and babies. Or they scale high fences or cling on to planes or risk their lives in dangerous waters in small crafts. We pray for peace, Lord. We pray for peace in Afghanistan and all corners of the world. We pray that those who wield weapons of war will have self-control and discipline. And we pray for the safety of all who are working in fear today. And may those people who are far from the front lines, the UN decision makers and global leaders and foreign ministers, act swiftly. Act swiftly, Lord, and surely. Give them your wisdom so that lives can be saved. Life-changing injury can be avoided. And those who dearly require protection receive. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Living God, we pray for all refugees seeking sanctuary at this time. We remember that we are a nation that has always welcomed refugees, welcomed in people from around the world. Generations. May we do what we can, along with all of the nations, may people be received with welcome. May we do what we can, where we can, with whatever we can. May your church support this work. A global network for a global crisis. We pray for all who lead your church, Lord. different denominations. This morning we pray for Her Majesty the Queen, Elizabeth, our Archbishops Justin and Stephen, our diocesan bishops from wherever we are gathered, praying here today for Bishop Paul and Bishop Sarah and their leadership team. Give them your grace and your vision, Lord. Your wisdom and your words. The gifts of your Holy Spirit. And we pray for your living water to flow, where in places it may feel like a mere trickle or a drop. We pray that your living water will flow through our lives and the lives of all our brothers and sisters, wherever they are today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for all who are suffering at this time in mind, body or spirit. We pray whatever their circumstances and wherever they are. We pray for strength and for courage. And we pray for all who care for them, praying today by name for John Ellison, Jessica McCaskill, Carrie Waggett, Doreen Moig, Andrew Garvick, Mrs. Hewitt, Sid Harrison, Pat Middleton, Dorothy Macbeth, Stella Matthews, Michael Hughes, Chris Haynes, John Pike, Anne Taylor, Rod Taylor, Carol Woodfield, Christine, Beatrice Yorston, Wynne Alderslade, Gillian, Mavis, Grant Macbeth, Susan Fisher, Ruth Banks, James Shepherd, Marjorie Carruthers, Brian Henderson, Anne Henderson, Brenda Prophet, Stan, Gary, Jim, Joan Thorburn, Ashton, Marion, Betty Hall, Isla Muhammad, Gary Patterson, Jonathan Hall, June Barris, Irene McConaughey, Judith, Derek Yorston, Tracy, Valerie, Tawny, Lisa, Michelle, George Dunn, Marjorie Towell, Maureen McLaughlin, and all the people on our hearts today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And loving God, we pray for all who are seriously ill right now. We pray for anyone in receipt of end-of-life care. We pray for their relatives and friends. Loving God, we pray for all who have died recently. And we pray for the repose of the soul by name for Lena McLeod, Raymond Walker, Lillian Owens, Daniel Dunn, We pray for all who are grieving for them at this time. We commend to you all who have departed this life, as we commend Lena, Raymond, Lillian and Daniel into your eternal care, remembering all those we love but no longer see. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. Our collect for today, O God, you declare your almighty power, most chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Mercifully grant to us such a measure of your grace, that we, running the way of your commandments, may receive your gracious promises and be made partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil, and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you, Carol. Tracy's put, the beauty of intercession is that God hears and understands. Giving thanks that we come so close to his heart and carry so much, and so many others there too. Sorry, I forgot to have just a time of silent prayer for you. Please do make that space. Lorraine, yes, we need to remember the children who are forced to fight against their will. Just picking up on your comment, freedom and justice for everyone. So, what's happening today? Our next service on this Facebook page is at 10 o'clock, Holy Eucharist. And then we have our mini munch pop-up, our holiday activities, at 11 o'clock. So you can pick up a picnic lunch between 11 and 1 at St. Paul's Church, next to Jarrow Hall, or St. Peter's Church on York Avenue. We'd love to see you. Just come over for a chat. It's always nice to meet families in Jarrow and Simonside. So whatever you are doing today, let's just keep our brothers and sisters, wherever they may be, and whatever their need may be, just hold them before God and ask for his grace and mercy. Lord, thy will be done, thy kingdom come. Let me send you on this morning with God's blessing. May God bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you this day and always and grant you his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit remain with you and those who you love this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. And Emma will be with you again tomorrow morning. Bye-bye.